Hello everybody. I come today with a very strange question for me, but you ask it very often. Is fasting healthy? You know, I'm since 40 years, 50 years as a physician in the domain of fasting active. And it's like if you would ask me, is sleeping healthy? Is eating healthy? Of course it is. It is necessary for your life. And it has a lot of health benefits for free. But of course, you can eat the wrong way. You can sleep too much or too less. The same. You can also fast in the wrong way. And you can fast too much. You can fast too less. You can fast too strict. Sometimes you need some supplements. And then there is another point. You should also be careful the way you reintroduce the food. The way you reintroduce the food is extremely important. So let us look what is healthy in the function of fasting. First, it's physiological. We are programmed as humans, like the animals, in our brain during the night to sleep and fast. So some functions have to happen during daytime, other during the night, and fasting should be overnight and should be every day. So the question is how long? Normally you sleep during 9 to 10 hours, then it's the time you should also fast. But today, some people recommend, and especially if you are overweight, if you have some problems like metabolic problems, diabetes, this kind of thing, or you are too stressed, then you might fast longer than the time you sleep. But it's very similar. Sleep is not the absence of activity, is a full function for itself, is a function where you reorganize your brain, your mental activity, your emotionality, where it's a really an active process for your emotional balance. The same for the fasting. If you don't fast enough during the day and during the year, then you come in a situation of chronic fasting deprivation. And this is what happens in our time. People are obese in our countries, in our industrialized countries, because they don't fast enough, or maybe because they eat wrong and they don't move. There are a lot of reasons, but the deficit of fasting is something you should really realize and correct. There is another big rhythm, not only the circadian rhythm, but there is another cosmic rhythm, that is the rhythm of the seasons, meaning in 1 year, the Earth turns around the sun, and this determines the seasons. During a season, which in our countries would be the winter, the Earth produces nothing, and the animals are either migrate or they sleep. They are hibernating. And humans have nothing to eat. So in the times where there was no possibility to import food, to conserve food with the technologies of today, humans also had to fast during long periods. It's what we call the long-term fasting. This is what we do in the Boehringer Wilhelmi clinics. We offer programs with 5 days, 10 days, 15 days, 20 days, sometimes more of fasting, always with the transition phases before and after, and the period of food reintroduction, which has to be very selective according to diseases, if there are some. If you want to know how to fast long-term the right way, I wrote a book, and the book title is in the description. So fasting needs to be reintroduced in your life during enough hours during the night and every year. If you do a long-term fasting, we recommend to do it in a special setting with medical supervision and a multidisciplinary accompaniment with fitness trainers, with physiotherapists, with masseur, with a psychologist, and a lot of people taking care of you, giving you confidence so that you can really enjoy all the dimensions of the fasting, which is not only the medical, but it's also the community dimension, and it's also the spiritual, inspirational. There are other videos where you can find those topics described. Now, fasting is healthy, of course, because it's part of your metabolism, it's part of your physiology. Now, the real question is, how long is it healthy to fast? Is it one day or some hours? Is it 1 week? Is it 1 month? And of course, this depends on your health, your age, your weight, and also on illnesses or health status at the moment where you decide to fast. And the other question is, how frequently should I repeat that in a month tempo or every year? So the next question would be supplementation, yes or not, how much? And for us, another very important question is quality of nutrition before and especially after the fasting. So all these questions are very individual. It's impossible to answer to everybody having all these individuals' baseline situations. So I will give you the recommendation we give in the Buchinger Wilhelmi Clinic, and this is fast every day for some hours. If you have a normal weight, 10, 12 hours, 14 hours is very healthy. And if you have an overweight or metabolic diseases or any type of inflammatory situation, then sometimes until 16 hours, this can be healthy. But at least 10 to 12 hours is important. Not eat during the night. This is even called the night eating syndrome. People wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning or 2, and they just go into the refrigerator and eat. It's not the moment. It's very bad for your sleep, but of course it's bad for your metabolism. And you never allow the positive effects of the fasting, one of the many, which is diminishing the glucose and the insulin and diminishing the IGF-1, which is the situation where the metabolism can regenerate and reset. So the second recommendation of Buchinger Wilhelmi is every year find the time for a long-term fasting. And for some people, 5 days are already good. For others, 10 days, 15, 20, and for some people, more. There is an old publication of the 70s where very overweight, young, sportive man fasts for 372 days without nothing, just water and some vitamins. So it's possible if you are extremely overweight to have long periods, but most of the people will profit very much from a long-term fasting of 5 to 20 days and sometimes a bit more. For illnesses, fasting for illnesses, is it healthy? And this, in our clinics, we see every individual long hour during which we can really see the situation of this person and recommend the length, the frequency, and the supplementation individually. And it's impossible to give a recommendation like this. The only thing you can do is to say for persons with metabolic syndrome, meaning obesity, high blood pressure, diabetes type 2, or insulin resistance, you should fast long. Let's say 3 weeks, 4 weeks, stay, meaning maybe 21 days of fasting or 15 days of fasting, and then switch back to food with a kind of ketogenic diet, so limiting the carbs and giving high good fats and all the other pillars of health, exercise, healthy sleep, etc., what I told before. And then now, maybe an aspect that I would like to stress. Researchers in animals, especially in big animals, which are much better to study the human, to imagine that there is a correspondence to human metabolism with the emperor penguins in the Antarctic or with big birds migrating. And this is our partners of the National Research Center in Strasbourg in France, who are big experts of the fasting in penguins, for instance. And they describe three phases of fasting. The first phase is from day zero, when you stop the food intake and you have what we call the metabolic switch. This means the glucose is not coming from the food anymore because there is no food anymore, or very little in the case of our minimal supplemented fasting. And you have this diminution of the glucose, of the insulin, of the IGF-1. You have the ketosis, the beta-hydroxybutyrate, which is increased. And all the effects I quoted in other videos, you have a genetic switch, activation, desactivation of the mTOR, of the RIS, PKA, and enhancement of the antioxidant capacity, diminishment of the inflammatory processes, etc. All the positive effects of fasting during probably 3 to 5 days. In the penguin, it seems to have a bit more, but in humans, as far as we as clinicians can see, it lasts around 3 days at least to reach the maximum ketosis, and then it plateaued until the end. After 3 days, more or less, we have a phase of protein sparing called phase two. And this phase two in the penguin can reach 60 days. In humans, normal weight, it can reach between 30 and 50 days. For instance, I would fast as long as possible. I would say probably 30 days. It's not always recommended because it depends on the age, and you can have the most benefits already with shorter periods. But it would be theoretically possible. So in humans, this phase two lasts around 40 days. And you spare the proteins in order to be able to leave much more from the fat, which you can, you have much more quantities. Energy stored as fat can last for much more days than energy stored in glucose, which we have very, very little reserves. So in this phase two, then the effects consolidate. And then in animals like the penguin, the researcher observed the phase three, which is the phase where starvation starts. And they observe an increase of the protein catabolism because the fat is almost finished, and they have to use protein in an accelerated way. And this is, of course, not what we reach when we let fasting people today do long periods because we don't want to reach that phase of starvation. But when the people use the word starvation as a synonymous for the words fasting, this is not right. This is a big mistake. We, as long as we are in phase two, we are fasting. And normally, at least in our clinics, we interrupt the fasting with food reintroduction at the day 5, 10. Here, I just put it at 20. In some cases, people want to fast longer and the doctors decide if it's good for them or not. So we have a form of fasting at Buchinger Wilhelmi where we recommend moderate exercise, but we notice that the people do in general 4 times more exercise than they do at home, with walks, with gymnastics, with yoga, with all sorts of stimulation, swimming, bicycling, etc. I think that it's enough to show you how healthy fasting is and unhealthy a chronic fasting deprivation is. Now, if you want to know exactly what you should do in particular diseases, you have to wait and be prudent. There are some offers on the market of fasting solutions or restrictive diet solutions that bring some of the effects of the fasting. And for a first step, we have ourselves developed what we call the fasting box, but it's a five-day reset program with 600 calories and a good accompaniment on the internet. This is something I would recommend to you for making just a try. It's not a real fast, like I say, but it's it brings some of the effects of the fasting, and you can see that it's possible and see how your body reacts, and maybe notice already the well-being after 1 or 2 days of transition, and then the long-term fasting needs a special setting. And like sleeping, fasting windows must take place at night for some hours. So every day, look that you have a pattern of fasting which correspond to the pattern of eating. But when you when you wake up, you shouldn't eat immediately, but wait until you have a healthy appetite. You feel like eating, it's place in your room in your stomach, and you're digesting from the day before is finished, and you really are hungry. And this is the moment where you could eat. A longer fasting period yearly of 5 to 20 days, this is what I recommend to you, because it corresponds to the rhythm of the seasons. And like I said before, and I will conclude with that, for specific illnesses when it's not a metabolic disease, which we can wonderfully treat with fasting, long-term fasting, let's say 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, or an inflammatory, chronic inflammatory disease like arthritis, polyarthritis, and headaches, asthma, allergies. These are the things and the diagnosis we are accustomed to treat with big success with long-term fasting, and then a good food reintroduction, correction of the modern nutrition, giving you nutritional guidelines and recommending you to do intermittent fasting in a right window of time. So yes, fasting is healthy and it's a pleasure, and it's really nice to experience this capacity of your body you maybe don't even dream of. You don't even know that you have this program in yourself, so try it and do it regularly. I hope you had fun with this film and this little conference. I encourage you to look at the description. You will find a lot of interesting documents in it, and see you soon, I hope.